Hey, did you guys have last night's leftovers for dinner?
No, I made an omelette.
Well, Jake must have had them after school.
Yeah, except he hasn't been home yet.
Strange. Ah, well. Toast it is. Hey, have you eaten yet?
Yeah. It's student night at the uni cafe. $2 spag roll.
Maybe I should head down there myself.
Have any of you guys seen my book, Motherstone? I want to lend it to a friend.
A friend?
Another geek, clearly.
Yeah, well, she's got the first two in the trilogy, and she's got to read the third one, because it's brilliant.
Are you sure you want to lend your books out? Remember what happened to your cricket, don't you?
Well, Danielle's not like Chelsea. Besides, she gave me some of her books. I'm just returning the favour.
Well, good for you.
Ah, here we are. Now, there's a couple of full rolls on the bench if you want them.
Lay down the quickie here.
Oh, I'm just going to see Tama and then I want to get some groceries for the party tonight.
Maybe we shouldn't count our chickens.
You're just nervous. Look, I know you said it wasn't needed, but I can still come if you want me to.
Nah, okay, goodbye. Go on off you. And beers as well as bubbly, please.
Of course. Can't get dead.
Bye.
Okay, and good luck. Not that you'll need it. Kia ora, Chris, can I?
Thanks. You're set.
Big time already, eh?
Yeah, come on, let's get it over with. Then you can get on with your life, forget the whole thing.
Maybe what town, nothing.
You don't sound very convinced.
Well, I'm not as confident as she is, let's put it that way.
Yeah. Victor, I do know how you're feeling. You know, all that crap I went through with Tash. I started to think that no one would believe me, but the truth came out. It always does. Trust me, it may not seem like it sometimes, but the system works. You didn't do it, you're not going down for it. End of story.
Hi.
Good morning, boss.
Oh, sorry about yesterday, eh?
When you gave me this job, you didn't say anything about sole charge.
Oh, I said I'm sorry. Okay, I'll pay you extra.
Jeez, you look terrible.
He said he doesn't want to get back together again, ever.
Right.
So I guess your job's been made permanent after all.
Hell, look, I can keep things ticking over here if you need more time out.
I don't know what I need. But I'm sorry.
Hey. Judy. You spoken to Chris?
I speak to Chris every day.
About leaking Victor's name?
Chris was busy. I don't think he wanted to know.
So it's still our little secret.
I have a handover to get to.
Have a good day.
So, what'll it be?
What's up with Shannon?
Boy troubles.
Oh, yeah?
She's not in a good state. She left me to lock up this place last night without so much as a phone call. You a good friend of hers?
Well, sort of, but not lately.
Shame. From what I could see, she could do with someone right now.
Damn. That's got to put you off your food. What's up with that bit?
What's wrong with it is that it's been cut open and mutilated so that it could be milked twice a day for its gall bile.
Why?
Well, because some people think it's good for you. It's just disgusting, eh?
Of course, if you chose not to charge me for this movie, I could donate the price of it to the cause. Free the farm bed. Yeah, I could let you sit here for free all day, and then I'd have to tell your dad you were wagging.
Hey, you like a coffee?
Oh, in about 15?
Yeah, okay, I'll wait.
Chuck.
I'm not getting any better, am I?
Well, you're not doing as well as we'd hoped. But I'm prescribing another antibiotic to help fight the pneumonia. That should do the trick.
I just want to go home.
I know, but we need to get those lungs right first. Once you're breathing more easily, we can discharge you. In the meantime...
I have to stay put. Don't worry, I know the drill. You're lucky I've a lot of reading to do.
Oh, Morris G. I'm not sure how many books he's written, but I can't seem to keep up.
You're obviously not trying. I'm whizzing through this one.
Motherstone.
Have you read it?
No, I haven't.
It's for young people, really, but that's never stopped me. A fellow fanatic lent it to me, young high school girl. A real sweetheart. She dropped it off this morning.
Okay, bye-bye.
Bye.
So how was Dad this morning?
Not bad, actually.
Yeah, it's pretty stink, though, that he didn't want us to go to the hearing.
Yeah, but it was like he said, he doesn't need us there. He's got Chris Warner and the lawyer. Plus, it'll be over in a couple of hours and then back to normality. Can't wait.
Are you going to go back up north?
Aye. And I dare say that your father will skip over and see Donna and Oz. I'll probably just stick around and make sure that Tom is okay. Truth be told, though, I can't wait to get back up north. I really miss it.
Yeah, I know what you mean.
You're missing Sydney?
All the time.
You and Maya are good, though.
Yeah, she's trying her hardest. It was pretty obvious, though, the other night. She told her flatmates to be nice to me. It's like I was this retard that they all had to tiptoe around.
Oh. No, you'll get there. Once you get to know the people, you'll see.
And let the nurses know that we'll be keeping in for a few more days yet.
Sure. Anything else? Everything all right?
That book that Danielle had.
Ah, the Morris G.
It's Scarlett's. She said to me last night that she had a friend she was going to lend it to.
Oh, well, that's very thoughtful of her. Or not.
Why is my daughter hanging around a terminal cancer patient?
Well, as you said, Scarlett is lonely. She needs to make some new friends.
Yeah, friends her own age, not a middle-aged woman dying of cancer. What's wrong with the girl?
Well, obviously, Scarlett and Danielle get on well. They both share a love of reading, so...
She's dying of cancer, Sticky. She shouldn't be encouraging her. It's selfish.
What, so Danielle only has a few months to live, so she shouldn't be allowed to make new friends?
Scarlett is 14 years old. Her best friend just went to Australia, and there were enough tears over that. So what's going to happen when Danielle... Oh, it doesn't matter. Hello, Craig Valentine. Yes, Mr. Pree, what can I do for you? You're joking. No, of course you're not. Yeah, 5 o'clock will be fine. Yep, I'll see you then. Bye. Kids, if ever you are thinking of becoming a parent, don't.
The police are going to need a whole lot more than they've got before anyone takes us seriously, am I right?
Definitely. I understand you're a single malt man, Victor. I enjoy a wee dram myself, so when we come out...
It's my shout, is that what you think?
It's thirsty work demolishing the opposition. Shall we?
Got to get to work.
Yeah, no kidding. Jim's been trying his hardest, but his... That white's just ain't nothing compared to yours.
Oh, get lost, Billy.
And what's the deal with leaving him alone to lock up the calf? You know, he's new. He could take anything.
That is none of your business.
I think it is. I care about you, okay?
Get out of my way.
Are you still in that boarding house? Jim says you've been trying to get back with your ex and that things are going a bit...
Jim should mind his own business. What are you two, best of buddies?
Look, he's worried about you, and so am I. Look, Shannon, I'll say it once and I'll say it again. Come and stay with me at our rancho. Norman's room's still free if you want.
Listen to me, Vinny. Look, every morning, when I wake up just for a few seconds, I forget where I am. I think that I'm back at Uncle Victor's house, at home, in bed with Tama beside me, and then I open my eyes and I find myself in that hole. And why am I there? Whose fault is it that I'm there? So why the hell would I want to accept any help from you? Why would I want anything to do with you?